Alright, what's going on, guys? And welcome back for some more Tales of Zestiria. And as you can see, I am in front of the Gefaris Ruins. Just so we can save up a little bit of time and I don't have to walk here and stuff. So right now we're gonna enter Gefaris Ruins and first of all find Old Man, and then we'll also try to find the Iris Gem that is inside. As you know, we have been here before, but we couldn't really do anything here yet, so let's see what's going on now. Now that we have all four elemental powers, as you can see here under the mini-map. Right. Maven said he had errands to run at the Great Camelot Bridge. A real shame. I was hoping we could kick back with a pitcher of ale for a bit. It's been so long. Oh man, dude, really? So at the Great Camelot Bridge, he is right now, right? Alright, the Great Camelot Bridge. Yeah, bridge. Therefore, let's now explore the ruins that we have, you know, more abilities available to us. And also, I found out during my offline, my off-camera play. Oops. Alright, first of all, I have to defeat these guys first. Also, guys, I think for now I'm gonna change the battle difficulty to intense. For normal battles. I mean, here we have been here before and the enemies are not that strong, so oh no, you know what? Let's keep it on hard. Yeah, I don't wanna overdo things. Alright, let me heal Sorry and Dazzle real quick. Alright. And I also found out you can kind of warp through here, so kind of like this. And my AP just increased by 2 for some reason.
It seems there's a treasure chest near us.
All right, we got some glacial earrings. Okay, let's continue onwards then. Ah, there's some herbs.
There must be herbs around here.
All right then. Anything here? Alright, just a skeleton. Okay, some more food. At least the Gefaris Ruins, the upper Gefaris Ruins. Alright, let's go up then. Oh, there seems to be something here. Alright, cool. Let me check it out real quick. Why are there farmers inside ruins? Like, that's something I really want to know, actually. First of all, let me check if anything's here. Yep, a chest.
Wait, that's...
Alright, some pink shirt.
Let's do some fortune.
Alright, what's here? Oh, it's just a normal door. Alright. Alright, what do we have? Chess?
So Ray, look around you.
Holy bottles and some good money. Cool. Any Normans around here maybe? Now we have Norman for the win. By this close proximity, Edna should be able to detect it. Let's go further here. Alright, we got some herbs, that's it. And also,
Saray, look carefully at the ground.
Okay, Norman.
Do you really think you can hide from me?
With Mirak. Should be somewhere here. Here? Alright. Mirak. Edna could use that. The iris gem seems to be here. Alright, fine, that was easy. I really thought I'm gonna waste a little bit more time in here. Ooh, some silver chests.
There might be something nearby.
Money. A sword. And oh man, I can't even get there yet. I will probably forget those chests. You guys know what, I'm just probably gonna do all this hidden chests off camera, and I'm gonna try to tell you guys what is inside. But also, we found out Silver Rose, which is, there's sort of a lot of focus, but man, that's about it.
It seems there's a treasure chest near us.
Earrings. A cheesecake. If you find a cheesecake in some ruins, don't you think it might be, I don't know, not edible anymore? I mean, it's just a guess, but... Up. There's a save point, so you guys know what's up. A boss battle coming up. Alright, are we healed up? Decently. Oops. Oh boy. Alright then, come here, boy. 46. Okay.
It's malevolent.
Whoa! So it's not a scorpion, but a scorpion-like creature?
You can look at it that way, but be careful, Rose.
It's resistant to multiple elements, so we'll need to observe their attack pattern. Okay, got it.
Don't let you die!
Rose, just a look! Abandon your task and focus within!
Saray, how long have you known Dezel?
Huh? About as long as you, I guess.
You don't sound too sure. Did you just meet him recently?
Well, I guess.
Recently?
Kind of recently.
I can't stand to watch this, but I'm not sure I want to join in.
Look at that great boy. 400 great boy. One with a single KO. Not bad, not bad. Alright, let's get this Earthen Astoria. Check what's up. Lila travels with an unknown young shepherd. A strong bond of trust unites them. Is Lila really that tall, or is the shepherd just really short, judging by this picture? Yeah, I think the shepherd's just short.
That was killer, Lila. You were in perfect harmony.
He was quite skilled despite his youth.
Yeah. Compared to him, you've still got a long way to go. Lila, I wish I could go on a journey like that with you.
Saray. Excuse you, Saray.
Huh?
Yes. This journey now is every bit as enjoyable as it was back then. Thanks to everyone here.
Well, we've met our first goal.
Well, it would have been nice if we could have investigated before the place got ransacked. But it looks like it happened a long time ago.
There's actually something I've noticed about that. Don't you think that the stones and decorations looted from here may have been used in Pendrago's architecture?
It's possible, given the location and the era.
Right. And if we can find out where they've been used, we might be able to find the hidden history of Pendrago.
If we compare with Lady Lake, which utilized the Vivia subterranean aqueduct, we might find what people in that era were thinking.
Sounds awesome! Good thinking, Miklio!
And that's not all. If we build upon our current hypothesis...
Hang on. I don't get what's so awesome about this.
But they're so enthused.
Enthused.
Friggin' weirdos.
Guess I'm the clown again.
No, that was a smile of praise to the true king of the Ruin Geeks.
Viva the Ruin Geek Shepherd.
What kind of shepherd is that?
I don't think I've ever heard of it.
Then that makes Saray the first.
No objections?
I guess.
We got Swordman's eye patch. Oh, we know who we need to give that to. But it doesn't really fit with the sunglasses. Maybe now that he's blind, he doesn't need... Yeah, for now, this should be okay. Alright, let's go back. I think I didn't check like half of this dungeon. So let me go up and check everything real quick. I know we checked this side of the ruins, but not that side, so let me do that real quick, actually. What's the fastest way? Okay, here.
After me!
Wait, did we check this monolith already? Alright, no. Wait, where are we right now? These two, four, one. Okay, so I think we should continue going this way.
Wait, that's...
some donuts. As I said before, I mean, these foods in the ruins, don't know if you can trust them or not. Alright, fire action going on here. Of course we cannot open one of the chests.
So Ray, look around you.
A gallant dog's tail. So curled. Many heroism. Wow. I do give the translation team that. They make it pretty funny.
Hold back.
Quite a fearsome fighting style.
All the way back up here. You know what? Screw it then. But I really do want to know what the hell is in there. I actually went up the wrong staircase. Oh. That's me, I guess. But this is such a long way back, yo. You know what? I would just come back here when I got the next key so I can unlock all the other treasure chests so that I don't waste so much time. I also did a little bit of exploring, and the Great Camelot Bridge is right there, but the thing is, that's a domain, that's a strong-ass domain that we cannot even enter yet, you know? So I have no idea where the hell Maven would be near the Camelot Bridge, man. That, or he's a cohort of the Lord of Calamity, which is unlikely, because... You know, Rose knows him like family, so I doubt he's a minion of the Lord of Calamity. But if he's really near the Great Camelot Bridge, then I have no idea where the hell he would be, actually. Because look at this. So I doubt we can even enter it yet. So, I mean, we could continue onwards, but the bridge is fairly long, look at that. So, I have no idea where Old Man Maven might be, but we have to skip that for now. Also, another thing that I discovered is another crucible. So let me actually save point travel to it, because I'm lazy like that. Here it is. And also, I found a monolith, but I didn't want to read it yet because I want to do it on camera. Combo effects. When you use the skill Exceed pile up combos of 5 or greater, the combo effects will be effective up to the 8th hit. Blast can also be used in combos of 5 or greater. Pressing R2 on the 5th hit of a combo will trigger partner blast. Some advanced stuff right there. I don't think I will be using that quite yet. Oops, I want to save. Alright, let's get into this crucible. I think it was Mikleos. Yep. Alright, I hope it doesn't take as long as Lila's, man, because that took forever.
For battle. Lunar strike! Spiral strike! Searching current!
Oh, let's look at the arts real quick. Alright, that's Twin Flow. Violet Storm.
Searching current! Water!
Wow, damn. Oh no, the eels. Not the eels. Ow, dude. Damn. She sniped you with the wind lance, man. Ow. Gonna get rid of this dude. Oh my god. Too hard, probably because I could have done this way earlier, but anyways, we done it.
Good job, Mikleo.
Well, it wasn't too bad. No surprises.
Exactly. No need for me to enter the ring. My manservant Meebo was enough to handle the problem.
I worked my butt off, and that's the thanks I get?
Oh, was it hard? It was hard, wasn't it? Sorry we asked too much of poor, feeble Meebo. Feebo. Fear not, dearly departed Feebo. Edna shall avenge you.
Oh my gosh, you have a comeback for everything.
For everything.
Stop that!
He's gotta know he's being played with. Why does he put up with it?
He puts up with all sorts of things. He's just that kind of guy.
Huh. I can see that.
Mikleo, you did it.
No, I didn't! Wait, I mean... Huh?
We got a Noble Quantum. Alright, is it better? I mean, it is kinda better, I guess. It does give me plus 10 water attack power, up 10%. Excuse me. But his art attack just goes down quite a bit. I don't think that's worth it. If I've done this a little bit earlier, then maybe, but now it's just too late. Alright, what to do next? Now that we've got the missing Malevolent Crucible off the way, what should we do now, Rose? Oh yeah, okay. I actually want to do some few things and, maybe Lake of Pendrago. Let's actually go back to Pendrago for a few things. You guys remember when we were here and we talked about Rose about the howling season thing? And she says, well, let me just go to sleep or something. Let me just get some food and then go sleep. That is actually exactly the thing we need to do. Because if you go sleep in here, and eat, what is... I don't care what I eat, but just eat some Drago stew, because that's delicious, what I've heard.
Sarate, you're not going to sleep yet?
Yeah, I want to take a look around the city.
It's so quiet that I can feel the gravity of the city's history. Fitting for an ancient capital born from the height of the era of Asgard.
It's kind of dawning on me. The things we read about in books actually exist.
What a poem this would make if we were travelers of old.
A poem? Ah, Pendrago, where the evening lights are blinding sights.
Come on.
Okay, it wasn't great, but I gotta start somewhere, right? What the?
What was that? Quit it, Mikleo.
It wasn't me.
Let's check outside.
See? That is exactly what we need to do. Isn't it funny? How, that random, I guess, statement of hers is actually a lead into a side quest. Well, as you can see, it's nighttime right now, and you just pretty much need to go to the castle diocese.
Was that Howl just now? Him?
I'm not sure, but this doesn't feel like his domain.
Yeah, it's not Mr.
Could it really be?
It's not Mr. Ganondorf. It's something else. Alright, dude. Who the hell's... Oh man, would you look at that? I actually don't know, he looks this big. All right, bro, come here.
There.
Not Kitty Beard, Kitty Tiger.
Oh my god, he's resistant to everything, every element.
What a fearsome roar.
That's the Beastmaster. It must be a Master Beast Demon who says it must be.
That's pretty blunt.
I'll have to avoid saying must in the future.
Rise and stand! Echo
Shelter! Rise and stand! Eat this! Eat this!
Eat this! Don't push yourself, Lila!
You feel it?
Wow. Dude. So cute. And Dazzle's also learned a new art, which is good.
It's a fat cat.
My, that's pretty rude of you. I prefer the term pleasantly plump.
Sorry.
Damn. Another dead lead.
Are you perhaps Morgrim?
Indeed I am.
Is she famous?
She's a high-ranking seraph who's a lone wolf, cat, and is imbued with a powerful blessing.
Whoa!
Alas, how shameful that you had to see that side of me.
This city is filled with the desires of greedy humans. I don't think you should feel responsible for it.
No, I must atone for it. Shepherd, you are looking for a seraph to bring the blessing to this city, are you not?
Well, this city is...
Pendrago is a big city. It's impossible to eliminate all the malevolence, and the church still holds the power.
But that means all the more that there are those who would cry out for salvation.
They're just turning to Seraphim out of desperation.
Yet are the people's wishes not genuine? I can still maintain the blessing with them.
But still, you could become a Hellion again.
I've got an idea. Why not use the church's authority against them?
I liked the sound of that. How do we do that?
Wait, do you intend to filter human prayers?
Pretty sneaky.
I've been pondering over the role of the blessing in human society.
Any conclusion?
It doesn't really do anyone any favors if I just take their prayers and give them the blessing in return.
Quite a lot of stress for nothing.
To coexist with humans in peace, there are many things that Seraphim must be conscious of.
I see. I hope the Seraphim you're thinking of will notice as well.
Oh, what a quick-witted lass.
Huh? You're not talking about yourself?
You mean another Seraph, yeah?
I truly hope they notice me and my efforts.
We understand your idea. We'll try and find an appropriate vessel for you.
Is the inscription of the Shrine Church still there? If we use that, I should be able to maintain a good distance with the believers.
It's still there. Please, Morgrim.
Shepherd, I know I have said much, but remember that I do not distrust humans.
It's just that humans and Seraphim need to know where they stand on the issues.
Yes, indeed. Both parties shall.
Morgrim sure is the cat's me. I mean, quite a person.
Yeah, even though she looks so fat, and I mean proportionate.
Malevolence, prayer, enshrinement, giving the blessing. We Seraphim ought to reconsider how we interact with humans, like Morgrim has.
We humans should do the same for Seraphim.
I think making that effort is the first step for peaceful coexistence, both for the Seraphim and humans.
But even Morgrim became a Hellion. Reality is cruel.
Yeah, so are you.
Let's not get too idealistic just yet, though, huh?
Right. There was so much malevolence in Pendrago that even Morgrim couldn't handle it by herself. We can't ignore that fact.
Maybe there's a reason why. A reason that might have something to do with the overflowing malevolence.
You may be right.
We shouldn't leave it all to Morgrim, and be sure to check up on her once in a while.
Yeah.
Alright, blessing for Pendrago region has been restored. Alright, we got some different colors for Dazzel. It better look good though. Oh wow! I think his swimsuit is gonna be okay for now. Alright, she's level 8. Let me set the boons first of all. Traveler's Repose. Traveler's Guide, of course. Drop rate boost, I guess. Sanctification because it's free. Now we have 4. There we go. Alright, what to do next? Oh yeah, Alicia, that's right. Alright, let's try to reduce the conversation page to 2. So first of all, let me go back to, Lady Lake. The shower room. First of all, we're gonna check on the kids.
I wonder what happened to Alicia.
Alicia also.
Let's go to her house.
Yeah. We need to check out on the kids and also, check out on Alicia. So we got a lot of things to do right now.